it's Susan, and today I'm going to do a chain pull. I call it a snowflake chain pull. I did one like this a few days ago. I'm going to do something very similar but with different colors. So I already applied my black base coat. It's fairly thin. It has to be kind of, can't be too thick for a chain or a string pull, otherwise the background color gobbles up the colors that you add on there. So I'm going to just loop it around like this. Drop that there, and I'm going to add my colors. My colors are white pearl metallic. I've got bronze, metallic bronze, gold, metallic gold, and then silver. So I'm just going to puddle the colors on in the loop part here, one there, there, and there. You don't have to use a whole lot because you're going to be using more than the one color, so right next to it. This is bronze, and I've got gold, fairly thick my paints for this. I'll just show you the consistency. It comes off the stick and it drops in a mound, it leaves a mound on the paint below. And silver. So maybe a little bit more. Then I'm going to just do a dab of white again. I got to move my paint over a bit. Okay, so I'm going to grab the end here, my tweezers, and then I'm going to just lift it up a little bit, and I'm going to pull slowly towards the middle as I'm not going to let it go all the way over. I'm just going to lift it up as the chain gets towards the middle, so that I just want it to end at the center of the canvas. So just go like that, and I'm going to just gently lift up as I'm pulling. Do the other side. Thank you. a lot of gold. Again, gently pull as I get towards the middle, just lifting it up. Okay, so now I'm going to do one here and here. So again, lift up as I pull. Now what I'm going to try to do, I'm going to do small ones in the middle here. So I think I'm going to pull this way. Actually, just one loop. And I'm going to hold it. Thank you. All right. That's done. It's not quite perfectly even, but it still looks cool. So, I think I'll have it like that. I'm going to put some dots in the middle from with the white. Just little ones. Maybe just a few that go on going out. I was thinking of putting some glitter on. Maybe just try to put some on in the middle. I'm not sure how this is gonna go because I don't want to spill it on the rest of it, so. I might have to use this stick here. I think that's good enough. All right, I will bring this in for a close-up for you. I don't know if you can see the glitter. You can't really, unless I... put it on an angle. You'll probably see it when it's dry. Oops, right now you can't see it. Unless I go real close. See it a little bit. See it a little bit here. Anyway, I will show you when it's dry. Hello, I'm back with the dried results. Really nice. I'm going to try and show you the sparkling, the glitter that I put on here. Okay, you can kind of see it here. It's hard to, really hard to see, but it's there. Anyway, here's a close-up. And see if I can put it in the sun here a bit more. There we go. There's a little bit of sparkle right there. So, thanks again for watching. Have a great day. See you in my next video. Bye for now.